Good morning, students. In the previous lecture of the hydrocarbon, we solved near about 1 to 12 questions of your exercise. In this lecture, we are going to solve the remaining exercise. And in this lecture, our chapter number 13 is going to be completed. Okay? So let's start with our next question, question number 13. How will you convert benzene into para nitro bromo benzene? Okay, we have to convert benzene into para nitro bromo benzene. So let's do this. First of all, I am going to draw benzene over here. Okay, so this is our benzene, and to make it look like your textbook, I am going to rotate it. Now let's make a double bond, so it will be completely benzene. Okay, so this is our benzene, and we have to convert benzene into para nitro bromo benzene. Now we need nitro as a para position, right? So for the para position, we know that nitro is meta directing group, whereas bromine is ortho para directing group. Nitro is meta directing, bromo is ortho para directing. So if we want nitro on the para position, we have to do bromination first. That's why as a first step, we are going to complete bromination. So plus Br2 in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3 or FeBr3, doesn't matter, any one of them can work easily. We will get, okay, let me select this. Okay, Control C, and Control V. So bromine will be added instead of hydrogen. In the place of hydrogen over here, so I am going to obtain bromo benzene, and as a byproduct, HBr will be reduced. Okay, now as a second step, I am going to complete the nitration, and for the nitration, I have to use concentrated nitric acid as a reagent as well as H2SO4, right? And for the nitration, temperature will be required, that's why delta on both of them. Okay, so there will be two products, one will be ortho product and one will be para product. Okay, bromine on both of them. It was there already. Now nitro group will be added in a one product on the ortho position and in the one product on the para position. Okay, so this is our complete chemical reaction of preparation of para nitro bromo benzene from the benzene. Okay, as a byproduct, H2O will be released. Okay, after that, our second reaction is meta nitro chloro benzene. We have to prepare meta nitro chloro benzene. I am going to clear it. So select and clear, delete. Now this is benzene. Okay, benzene going to react with, okay, now I want nitro on a para position, that's why I am going to do nitration first. So reaction with concentrated HNO3, okay, in the presence of concentrated H2SO4 at 52 60 degree Celsius. Okay, it will give me nitrobenzene as a product. Okay, so nitro will be added on the first carbon and byproduct will be H2O. Okay, in the second step we are going to do chlorination, and we know that nitro is metadirecting, that's why Cl2 will be required as a reagent, and anhydrous AlCl3 will be my catalyst. Okay, and delta will be there because we have to warm it. Okay, now our product nitro is already present and nitro is meta directing, that's why chlorine will be added on the meta position. So we got meta nitro chloro benzene. What is the difference between these two reactions? If we want ortho or para product, we will do chlorination or halogenation first, and if we want meta product, we will do nitration first. Okay, after that our third reaction is para nitro toluene. So let's do this, select and remove benzene para nitro toluene. So again para product, that's why we have to do Friedel-Crafts alkylation first, that's why plus CH3Cl in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3. So anhydrous AlCl3 in delta. Okay, we know that product of this will be toluene, and for the toluene CH3 will be added on the first carbon. Okay, this is the toluene, byproduct will be HCl, so minus HCl. In the second step we are going to complete the nitration, that's why concentrated HNO3 and H2SO4 will be required, right? And for that we have to heat it, that's why delta. Product will be ortho and para. So two products are there, ortho product and para product. Okay, in both of the product toluene is already there, so CH3 on first carbon. Now NO2 will be added in one on the ortho position and on second at a para position. Okay, so two different products will be there, ortho nitro toluene and para nitro toluene. We want para nitro toluene. So that was our third reaction. After that, reaction number 4, preparation of acetophenone. Okay, it is directly given in your textbook, preparation of acetophenone. You can see that over here. Look at this. This is the preparation of acetophenone they have given us over here. This is the preparation of acetophenone. Okay, you can follow this from textbook page number 401. Okay, that will be the answer of the fourth organic conversion. Now our next question, question number 14, which is very easy. First of all, question number 13 is most important for us, most IMP. Okay, now let's talk about question number 14. In the alkane, they have given us one alkane. Identify primary, secondary and tertiary carbon and give the number of hydrogen atoms bonded with each one of these. Let's discover the primary carbon first. There is a trick. if carbon is attached with the 3 hydrogen, it will be primary carbon. Okay, so this carbon is attached with 3 hydrogen, so it is primary carbon. Then here 2 carbons are there which are attached to the 3 hydrogens, and again here 2 carbons are there which are attached to the 3 hydrogens. So total 1 + 2 + 2, 5 carbons are primary carbon. Total 5 carbons are primary carbon, and on each carbon there is a 3 hydrogen. So 5 × 3, total 15 primary hydrogens are there. Okay, after that secondary carbon, a carbon attached to 2 hydrogens are always secondary carbon. So this is the secondary carbon, and this one will be also secondary carbon. So there are 2 secondary carbons and total 4 secondary hydrogens. Now tertiary carbon, carbon attached to 1 hydrogen will be tertiary carbon. So this carbon is the tertiary carbon. So there is 1 tertiary carbon and 1 tertiary hydrogen attached to that. And quaternary carbon, 1 quaternary carbon is also there, and there is no quaternary hydrogen at any cost. After that, question number 15, what effect does branching of alkane chain has on its boiling point? As the number of branch increases, atom becomes spherical. That's why the surface area of the atom decreases, and that's why boiling point also decreases. So as the number of branch increasing in the alkane chain, boiling point also decreases. That simple. Okay, after that, question number 16, addition of HBr to propene yields 2-bromopropane Markovnikov rule, while in the presence of benzoyl peroxide the same reaction yields 1-bromopropane Karsh effect, or you can say anti Markovnikov rule. Explain this and give mechanism. So this question is most important question for us, for 5 marker question and 4 marker question. Okay, they have given us Markovnikov and anti Markovnikov rule. You can see that on your page number 389. Page number 389 contains Markovnikov rule and anti Markovnikov rule. Your answer starts from here. Okay, Markovnikov, a Russian chemist, made a generalization in 1869. That will be starting of your answer. First they have given the Markovnikov rule as a product 2-bromopropane. After that they gave us anti Markovnikov rule with a major product 1-bromopropane. So both of them should be written up to here. Okay, your answer completes over here for 5 marks. So write it down as a point wise in your fair book. Okay, after that, question number 17, write down the products of ozonolysis of 1,2-dimethylbenzene. First of all, question number 17 is not included in your syllabus, it is from the reduced syllabus. Still, ozonolysis is a familiar concept, that's why we are going to solve it. After that, they asked us for the calculus structure of the benzene, how this result supports calculus structure of benzene. So we are not going to discuss about that. We are only going to do ozonolysis of orthoxylene, or you can say 1,2-dimethyl benzene. So let's do this. First of all, we will need benzene. So this is our benzene, and benzene have 1,2-dimethyl, right? So first carbon have methyl group CH3. After that, second carbon also have methyl group. So on the second carbon there is a methyl. This is orthoxylene, right? Now we want to do ozonolysis, and for that total 3 pi bonds are going to be broken completely. First broke, second broke, and the third broke. Okay, like this a whole benzene ring is going to be destructed into three parts. Okay. Now, for the chemical reaction, we are going to do both of the step at the same time. That's why our first step will be reaction with the ozone, and the second step will be reaction with zinc and H2O, right? Now let's talk about the product. Okay, we know that this carbon is containing one hydrogen and this carbon is containing one hydrogen. That's why carbon hydrogen, and that carbon is connected to another carbon hydrogen, right? Two bonds of this carbon has been deducted, that's why here double bond oxygen, and two bond of this carbon is deducted, that's why double bond over here. Likewise, a similar thing happens over here, that's why total two products will be there, CHO, single bond CHO, which is known as a glyoxime. Okay, this is glyoxime, and another product will be this CH3 instead of hydrogen. So carbon instead of hydrogen, there is a CH3 connected to another carbon which have CH3, and both the carbon have two leftover bonds, that's why double bonded oxygen on both of them. So this is dimethyl glyoxime and this is glyoxime. Okay, now we know that pi bond of benzene is going to be continuously convert into each other. That's why we are going to convert this on the opposite side. Okay, let's do this. So this was our first product. Now we are going to do a same thing again, but with a different proposition. Okay, so I am going to draw a new benzene over here. So this is our benzene, going to rotate it up to 90 degrees. Okay, now pi bonds, first pi bond, okay, that was already there. So now alternate pi bond, first pi bond, second pi bond and third pi bond. Okay, and this is better drawing, that's why I am going to copy it. Now orthoxylene, that's why first carbon has a CH3 and second carbon also have CH3. Okay, we are going to do ozonolysis again, that's why reaction mechanism will be copied from here, control C and control V. Okay, reaction mechanism copied. Now we know that how bond are going to be broken, right? So here this double bond is going to be broken, here this double bond is going to be broken, and here this double bond is going to be broken, right? Now look at the product. Look at the product. Okay, so our first product will be glyoxime, the same one that is over here. So CHO, single bond CHO. Okay, glyoxime, glyoxime. So one product will be glyoxime and another product, so here CH, so one will be CHO and other one will be C double bond O and CH3. This is methyl glyoxime, this is dimethyl glyoxime, and this one will be also methyl glyoxime. So two methyl glyoxime and one glyoxime will be there, here two glyoxime and one dimethyl glyoxime will be there. So total three different products will be there. One will be glyoxime, another one will be dimethyl glyoxime, and third one will be methyl glyoxime by the ozonolysis. Okay, so that was your question number 17. After that, question number 18. Arrange benzene, normal hexane and ethyne in decreasing order of acidic behavior. We know that that depends on the hybridization. As the S character increases, acidic character increases. So we know that here benzene is sp2 hybridized, hexane is sp3 hybridized, whereas ethyne is sp hybridized. So in ethyne S character is 50%, in benzene S character is 33.33%, and in hexane S character is only 25%. So as the S character increases, the carbon will be more electronegative and it will be more polar. That's why it is easily going to donate the H plus, or you can say proton. So ethyne will be the most acidic among these three. So first will be ethyne in the acidic order. After that, second will be benzene, lesser than ethyne, and normal hexane will be lesser than ethyne and benzene both. So third one will be hexane. Ethyne will be most acidic, second acidic will be benzene, and third acidic will be hexane. Okay. After that, 19th question, why does benzene undergo electrophilic substitution reaction easily and nucleophilic substitution reaction with difficulty? Why does benzene undergo electrophilic substitution reaction easily and nucleophilic substitution reaction difficult? Because benzene have 3 pi bonds which is continuously resonating. Because of that, these 3 pi bonds are delocalized. That's why benzene have 6 delocalized electron. So that we can say that benzene is electron rich molecule. That's why it is easily going to react with electrophile, because electrophiles are positively charged, whereas nucleophile are negatively charged. That's why electrophilic substitution reaction are easy, whereas nucleophilic substitution reactions are difficult for benzene. Okay. After that, your question number 20. First of all, question number 20 is most important for you guys. How would you convert the following compounds into the benzene? Okay, first compound is ethyne. So there was a cyclic polymerization from where we prepared benzene in the properties of alkyne. We have already studied that, right? So this one will be the answer of the first question, preparation from ethyne. Ethyne in the presence of red hot iron tube at 873 Kelvin will be converted into benzene. This one will be our first reaction. On the page number 396, remember that, on the page number 396, our answer is there. Note it down, okay? After that, preparation from ethene. So it is also on the page number 196. In the problem 13.14, look at this, last steps, CH2 after the bromination converted into vicinal dibromide, and vicinal dibromide after the beta elimination converted into ethyne, and ethyne after the cyclic polymerization converts into the benzene. So that portion which I have highlighted is your answer of the second conversion. This answer is into the problem 13.14. Okay, so write it down from there. After that, preparation from hexane. It is into the chemical properties of alkane. They have given this into the chemical properties of alkane. Okay. Aromatization, look at this aromatization. Okay, page number 382 contains your third answer. Page number 382 contains your third answer, aromatization, where hexane is converted into benzene at 773 Kelvin temperature, 10 to 20 atmospheric pressure, and in the presence of chromium ऑक्साइड और वेनेडियम पेंटोक्साइड और MO2O3 इट कन्वर्ट्स इनटू बेंजीन. ओके दैट विल बी योर आंसर ऑन द पेज नंबर 382. ओके After that, next question. Write structures of all alkenes which on hydrogenation gives 2-methylbutane. Okay, let's do this. We want 2-methylbutane. Okay, 2-methylbutane. That's why, first of all, 4 carbon in a straight line for the butane and 2-methylbutane. So, 1 carbon over here. Okay. Hydrogen, you have to put down hydrogen on every single carbon, right? 3 hydrogens will be over here, 3 over here and 3 over here. 1 on second carbon and 2 on the third carbon. Okay? We want this alkene, 2-methylbutane from alkene, all the possible alkenes which is going to convert into this compound. Okay? So, we cannot change this structure. We have to follow this structure. Okay, so I am going to copy it so I do not have to write every time. Now, first of all, I am going to put down a double bond over here. Okay, so CH3, two bonds are there already. So CH2, CH, CH. Okay, so name of this compound will be 3-methylbutanine will be converted into 2-methylbutane by the hydrogenation in the presence of platinum, palladium or nickel. Okay, 3-methylbutanine. After that, our second compound, we are going to change the place of a double bond. Okay, so CH3 and CH3. Here 4 bonds are there, so 1 hydrogen over here. This is 1, 2. So 2-methylbut-2-ene will be also going to converted into this compound in the presence of platinum by the hydrogenation. Okay, and the third compound will be something like this. We are going to change a place of a double bond again. Now double bond is over here, so this one will be 2-methylbut-1-ene. Put down the hydrogen on yourself, okay? In the presence of H2 NPT. So we have total 3 compounds. One will be 3-methylbut-1-ene. After that 2-methylbut-2-ene, and after that 2-methylbut-1-ene. Okay? Your next question. Arrange the following set of the compounds in order of their decreasing relative reactivity with electrophile. We know that nitro is deactivating agent. So, as the amount of nitro increases, ring will be less reactive towards the electrophile. So, chlorobenzene do not have any nitro. Here 2 nitro are there. Here only 1 nitro is there. So, first compound with most reactivity will be chlorobenzene, on the second place para-nitrobenzene, and on the third place 2,4-dinitrochlorobenzene. In the second, we have toluene, we have para-nitrotoluene, and we have 1,4-dinitrobenzene. So here no nitro group is there, so this one will be the most reactive. Here 1 nitro is there, so second place will be para-nitrotoluene and third place will be dinitrobenzene. Okay, after that, question number 23, out of benzene, meta-dinitrobenzene and toluene, which will undergo nitration most easily? Most reactive will go under the nitration most easily. So toluene will be the most reactive because CH3 is ring activating agent, whereas nitro is ring deactivating and benzene is at a middle. That's why toluene will go in under the nitration easily. Okay, after that, question number 24, Suggest a name of the Lewis acid other than anhydrous AlCl3 which can be used during the ethylation of benzene. We can use FeCl3, we can use FeBr3, we can use SnCl4, we can use BF3, we can use BCl3. Any other Lewis acid can be used which have electron deficiency on the central atom. Okay. After that, question number 25. We have already solved it. Why is Wood's reaction not preferred for preparation of alkane containing odd number of carbon atoms? Illustrate your answer by taking one example. We have already solved it. Check out the own live lectures. Recorded lectures. I am going to show it in the preparation of alkane. Open the lecture which have preparation of alkane, especially the Wood's reaction. Look at this. There is a question. What will happen if two different alkyl halides are taken? And same time, I told you that we cannot prepare odd number of alkane, odd number of carbon containing alkane using Wood's method. Why? Okay. So we have already discussed that answer in that lecture. So open that lecture and refer that answer also. Okay. So here, we have completed our chapter number 13. In the next lecture, we are going to start our new lecture, new chapter. Okay, so thank you so much.